It's the moment of solution. There is an answer.
The miracle you have so desired, in which you are waiting on God, you will receive it in Jesus'
name. Concerning that peculiar situation, victory is
assured.
And
you will testify of God's miraculous intervention in Jesus' name.
A blessing. There is a miracle
that
you need to obtain. And we shall all rejoice in your testimony. In Jesus' name.
Welcome to the Moment of Solution, which comes to you every week on Tuesdays. It's my prayer that today, the miracle you have so desired, in which you are waiting on God, you will receive it in Jesus' name. Our Bible passage for today is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 5, from verse 25 to 29. Mark chapter 5, verses 25 to 29. And a certain woman, which had an issue of blood 12 years, and had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and was nothing bettered, but rather grew worse. When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, "If I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole." And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. The first thing we need to take note of from this passage in discussing the topic, my time for a miracle, is, this passage says a certain woman. A name is not attached to it. And that tells me that this could be you. It could be any man. It could be any woman. It could be any individual with a desperate need, with a need for a divine intervention that can only be addressed by the God that does the miraculous things. And he will intervene on your behalf in Jesus' name. Her own need was health related, or yours could be otherwise. However, there is a provision for your situation in the encounter that this woman had with Jesus, a certain woman. The second point to take note of in this passage is she had an issue of blood. What does that mean? Blood was constantly being drained from her. And you know what the Bible says about blood? In Leviticus chapter 17, verse 14, the Bible says it is the life of all flesh. In other words, the blood is the life. It says the blood of it is for the life thereof. Of course, we all know without blood, there is no life. So when this woman was continuously losing blood, it will get to a point that replenishment by the body cannot cope again. And what does that imply? She was gradually losing her life, and her blood was being drained away. And this takes us to the third point, which was her desperation. The fact that life was gradually being drained from her led to her desperation. She became desperate. She had gotten to the point of desperation for the desired result. When Esther was in a similar situation, her people had been sentenced to destruction. There was seemingly no hope anywhere. She realized that she needed to go and see the king. But nobody could just go and see the king except by invitation. And Esther realized that this was a point of desperation. She had to go. She needed favor. She needed God's intervention. She made up her mind. If I stay here and I do nothing, my people will perish and eventually I will perish. But if I take a step of faith in desperation, I might be able to save my people. Moreover, when I put in some days of prayer and fasting, together with my people, victory is assured. And I want to tell someone who is listening to me at this moment, concerning that peculiar situation, victory is assured.
and you will testify of God's miraculous intervention in Jesus' name. In Esther chapter 4 verse 16, Esther said, "Go gather together all the Jews that are present in Shushan and fast ye for me." You may need to fast that miracle may be obtained. She said, "Neither eat nor drink 3 days, night or day. I also and my maidens will fast likewise. And so will I go in unto the king, which is not according to the law. And if I perish, I perish." Brethren, we know that Esther did not perish. That's why her desperation is an example for us. All she needed to do was to fast for 3 days and three nights. Maybe you never fasted before. To get that miracle, you may need to do the same. Fast for 3 days and three nights. It doesn't kill. You will live to testify. The Lord is talking to someone who is watching this program. You need to go for that 3 days program. He's been talking to you before now. You've been hedging. You've been hesitating. It's time for you to go before the Lord in your desperation, because there is a solution waiting for you. There is a blessing. There is a miracle that you need to obtain. Go for it. And we shall all rejoice in your testimony. In Jesus' name. So this woman had done every other thing that she could do, medically, financially, without any discernible results. But instead, she saw nothing but an end of failure. Do you look ahead and all you see is impending doom, impending failure? You need to be desperate, because your solution has come. The God that reveals in the miraculous will give you that miracle today in Jesus' name, because it is your time for a miracle. It is my time for a miracle. It is our time for a miracle. Number four, this woman, however, heard about Jesus and her faith was recharged. She heard about Jesus. Hope sprang up in her. Her determination took over from her desperation. I present to you today Jesus, the one who changes hopeless situations and gives the hopeless man hope, the one who turns all situations around, the God that reveals in doing the impossible. She heard about him. You are hearing about him now. He's ready. He's prepared to give you that miracle. But you know what? Number five, she did not just hear about Jesus. She came to him. He has an outstanding invitation for you. He has never withdrawn it. He's reiterating it. He's repeating it now. In Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 and 29, listen to what he said. He said, "Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you will find rest unto your souls." You've been running around. You've been looking for solution everywhere. You've spent money. You are spiritually spent. But he's saying, come. I have the solution for you. I have a miracle for you. That woman did not just hear about Jesus. She came to him. That was the beginning of the end for that problem in her life. That was the beginning of that glorious solution that we are talking about today. In Revelation chapter 22, verse 17, the Bible says, "And the Spirit and the bride say, come." You see, that's an invitation for you. Come. "Let him that heareth say, come. Let him that is athirst, come. Whosoever will, let him take this water of life freely." Freely. Jesus is reaching out to you right now, and he's saying, "That lady came, you too, come. Your miracle is with me." Your situation, no matter how gargantuan it seems, I have a solution for you. You will receive that solution in Jesus' name. Number six, she put her faith in action by touching Jesus. Do the same right now. Throw yourself upon Jesus. Touch him with your infirmity. Touch him with your expectations. go to him and say, Lord, no one else can solve this problem. I've tried. Intervene on my behalf. He will answer you. He will heal you. He will answer you. He will give you a miracle right now. He will answer you. He will give you a testimony. So shall it be in Jesus' name. 5 prayer points from today's moment of solution. Number one, you say, Father, have mercy upon me today and touch me at my point of need. Pray that prayer as if you mean it. Say, Father, have mercy upon me. Touch me at my point of need. Oh, your point of need might be the salvation of your soul. If that is the point, just say, Father, have mercy upon me. Jesus died for my sin upon the cross of Calvary. I repent. Come into my life. Forgive me of going around looking for solution elsewhere but with you. I've come now. I'm back. Take me. Write my name in the book of life. Have mercy upon me. Give me eternity. Give me my miracle. And he will answer you in Jesus' name. Prayer point number two. You say, Father, reward my faith at my point of need and make me a testimony. Reward my faith, O Lord, at my point of need. Make me a testimony in the name of Jesus. Father, reward my faith at my point of need and make me a testimony. Prayer point number three. It is my time for a miracle. Give me my desired miracle, O Lord. It is my time for a miracle, Father. Give me my desired miracle in the name of Jesus. It is my time for a miracle. Give me my desired miracle, O Lord, in Jesus' name. Prayer point number four. It's time for you to be specific. Now be specific. Tell him what you want him to do for you. What is it you want God to do for you? Oh, that's your prayer point number four. And it's a very important one. Because four is the number for creative miracle. Four is the number for God's creative work. So prayer point number four is key. Begin to key in. Tell him, Lord, this is what I want you to do for me. This is the miracle I desire. And he's answering you. He's meeting you. Yes, that warmth you are experiencing is the warmth of the presence of the Holy Spirit. It's the creative power of God operating in your life. And you will live to testify of his goodness in Jesus' name. And my prayer point number five, give thanks to God. Give thanks to him for what he has done. Yes, he's been good, he's been wonderful, he's been beautiful. He's been a glorious God. Oh, give thanks to him. Give thanks to him. Make sure that you testify of what God has done for you in this brief moment, in your church, in your local assembly, and give God all the glory. And your miracle will be permanent in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for joining me on this moment of solution. It's a very special one because it's your time for a miracle. Until I come unto you again next week, enjoy the miraculous working power of the living God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for watching today's episode of The Moments of Solution. Please remember to comment, like, share, and subscribe. God bless you.